Чистых вайшнавов являются такими же бесследными днями и великой возможностью для нас почитать их в этот день и таким образом обрести их милость.
Накарма банам джанма вайшнаванам навидите. Vaishnavas have no birth, no karmic bondage, and also no death.
У вайшнавов нет рождения, нет никаких кармических обусловленностей и также нет смерти.
By the will of the Supreme Lord, they are sometimes manifest prakat before our eyes, and sometimes become aprakat, unmanifest. But they are nitya, eternal personalities, and always present with their anugatya.
Лишь иногда по воле Господа, иногда они становятся прокат, проявляются для нашего видения, иногда они становятся апракат. Но они всегда, видите, они всегда вечные, и они всегда рядом с теми, кто следует за ними, кто их анукаджан.
Прабху кой ком ду кой гурута, Кришна бхактабера хабина на дука дакипар. Мабу asked, of all types of suffering, which is the greatest?
Махапрабху спросил, какой является самым суровым из всех видов страдания?
Sri Rai Ramananda replied, actually, I don't have any suffering in this world, but only one pain is there, that is birha, the separation from pure Vaishnavas.
Sri Rai Ramananda ответил, на самом деле у меня нет никаких страданий в этом мире, есть лишь одна боль, которую я испытываю, это боль разлуки с чистым Вайшнавом.
So the disappearance day of the Vaishnava is called Virha Mahotsav. The festival of separation.
День ухода чистого Вайшнава называется Вираха Махотсава, то есть день разлуки, фестиваль разлуки, праздник разлуки.
Ви means вишеш, especially.
Ви означает вишеш, особенный.
And раха means рахас, confidential.
А раха означает рахасия, конфиденциальный.
So вираха is one special, intense, confidential type of meeting, actually.
Поэтому вираха это особый, интенсивный. Очень сокровенный вид встречи.
So in the Biraha Mahotsav, Vaishnavas are blessed with a great opportunity to have the association of those great Vaishnavas.
И во время Бираха Махотсава преданные благословлены такой возможностью получить высочайшее общение этих великих Вайшнавов.
How much one feels Biraha separation from Gurudev and Vaishnavas will be exactly in proportional to how much they have surrendered and rendered seva to that Vaishnava.
Насколько преданный скорбит в разлуке со своим Гурудевом и с чистыми Вайшнавами, поэтому мы можем судить, насколько он был преданным и насколько он им служил.
Those who have not rendered this Niskapata Niswartha Guru Seva without any selfishness, without any duplicity, they will not feel separation.
Те, кто не совершали Нишкапата Нисварта Гуру Сева, то есть не служили без личных притязаний и без лицемерия, те не почувствуют этой разлуки.
And it's to be understood that that satsistya, that bona fide disciple, who is feeling separation from his Gurudev, that very soon he will attain the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna.
И мы должны знать, что тот садшишья, тот истинный ученик, который чувствует эту глубокую разлуку своим гуру, очень скоро идет служение лотосным стопам и Кришны.
Like our Srila Raghunatha Das Goswami Pad.
Как наш Шрила Рагунатха Дас Госвами Пад.
When his Шигуру Шрила Рупа Госвами left this world.
Когда его Шигуру Шрила Рупа Госвами оставил этот мир.
Шуньяйте Махабхустам Гриндро Джаграйте Вьягра Кундайте Кундам Дживату Рахитасхане. О, Рупа Госвами, now that you are no longer here, I feel as if the whole Braj Mandal is a shunya, empty.
О, Рупа Госвами, теперь, когда ты исчез, я чувствую, что вся Браджа Мандала опустела, стала шунья.
I have glorified Гирирадж Говардхан.
Я прославлял Гирирадж Говардхан.
Ниджаникатанивасам дейхи Говарданатхан. But now, Рупа Госвами, now that you've left, then, Гриндро Джагарайате, I cannot bear to look at Govardhan. It seems to be like the mouth of a python, ready to devour me.
Но теперь, Рупа Госвами, когда ты ушел, мне невыносимо даже взглянуть на Гирирадж Говардхан. Он кажется мне, словно питон, который разинул пасть и готов заглотить меня.
Before I glorified Sri Radha Kund.
Раньше я прославлял Шри Радха Кунду.
Ати Сурабини Кунда Мради, Ати Сурабини Радха Кунда Эйва Сриоми. But now when I look at Radha Kund, it seems to be like the mouth of a tiger.
Но сейчас, когда я смотрю на Радха Кунду, она подобна пасти тигра.
О, Рупа Госвами, я cannot live without you.
О, Рупа Госвами, я не могу жить без тебя.
So the feelings of separation from Gurudev, these are the symptoms of the advanced Vaishnava.
Чувство глубокой разлуки с Гурудевом – это признак продвинутого Вайшнава.
And for such a person, surely they will attain the lotus feet of Radha Krishna.
И непременно такой человек достигнет лотосных стоп Радхи Кришны.
So fortunately today we are most blessed that a very senior and dear disciple of Param Pujapad, Srila Bhaktivinoda Vaman Goswami Maharaj, is in our presence. My most beloved Sri Krishna Ananda Prabhu. So I very humbly request Sri Krishna Ananda Prabhu to offer his Shraddha Pushpanjali at the lotus feet of Param Pujapad, Srila Bhaktivinoda Vaman Goswami and Srila Bhaktivinoda Trivikram Goswami.
Поэтому я очень смиренно прошу Шри Кришнананду Прабху предложить свои Шрадха Пушпанджали, лотосный стоп Бхактивинанты Вамана Госвами и Бхактивинанты Тривикрама Госвами. Всегда давал возвышенную предкатую и очень остро обрывал всю мою вату.
My point is that, what is need of the source of wealth? How can Christianity have started? This is the lecture. This is
what is your need in a social life? How you can begin your life and from where you are? Beginning, like from the
And it's just that then you forget the mind, that Rupad Maharaj is a Rasa Bhav. He puts the Rasa Bhav very nice. And Maharaj first time go to West and come, first started with Mathura preaching very nice. Then Maharaj go there and the Vrajavasi and Hindi person, they not go to Navin Khan. Very clear that Maharaj comes to my brother room and Maharaj, so many person come to take a diksha from you. Then my brother says, no. I have given permission to you. You give the picture. Very grateful because he is a president at that time, Acharya. But he is nominated. No. It is your duty. You do picture and I see that. Great festival.
So what my good day will change in Madhura. But not so many people from there are coming to Madhura. And the old single Baba at the side of Madhura. And Gurudev was preaching and bringing some people to take diksha from him. Because you have a mind of you take a diksha, which is very unprecedented in Gaudiya, because you have a command is Acharya, and he was telling you to take diksha.
Yeah.
No competition at all.
No. Fresh, it proves of the other. Then one day, Sarasvara then comes, oh, we must sit in our room. Then what? How can you wake up in the morning? So then you see here, dressing up in the pocket. So, it is so many things I see.
So he is in Chinchura, that was the first press of Bodhidharma Swami. And he is working at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, all at night, printing the Pandaka. Then he is lying there, the accident, and how do you wake up in the morning?
Который сейчас там сейчас Бангладеш.
His mother was a disciple of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur.
Его мать была ученицей Прабхупады Шрилы Бхактисиддханты Сарасвати Такура.
And at first his father was not following.
И сначала его отец не следовал.
But his mother was a very strict disciplinarian.
Но его мать была очень строгой и дисциплинированной.
If the father would eat something which was not included in the category of Vaishnava Bhojan, she would lock the door, not let him in the house.
Если она узнавала, что ее муж чает что-то, что не соответствует вайшнавским принципам, она просто запирала дверь и не впускала его в дом.
Yes. And then later, then he became disciple initiated by our Param Guru, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami. Then he could come in the house. So, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bhavananda Goswami Maharaj, his uncle was Bhakti Bhushan Nishinga Maharaj, and he was already living in the mat. He was one of the early disciples of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur.
Извините, он был учеником
Шрилы Бхактисиддханты
Сарасвати
Такура.
Yes.
Это были 30-е годы.
So when he was about 9 years old, his mother brought him to the mat and gave him to our Param Gurudev to take care of.
И когда ему было всего лишь 9 лет, то его мать привела его в мат к Param Gurudev, чтобы.
Because at that time our Param Gurudev, Vinod Vihari Das Brahmachari, he was not commander, he was in charge of it.
И тогда наш Param Gurudev заведовал мат, его так звали Vinod Brahmachari.
So our Srila Bhaktivedanta Bhavananda Goswami Maharaj, when he was a boy, he received Harinam from Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. But in December 1938, Srila Prabhupada became unmanifest from this world. So from the beginning, our Param Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Maharaj, always took care of the Srila Bhakti Maharaj like his own child. He used to say, oh, if you can learn this verse, I'll give you one chocolate. So he began learning many verses every day. And Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur was established in Mayapur, a school called the Bhakti Nod Institute. So as a boy, he was living in a mat and studying in that school, and he was always the top of the class. He was a Suti Dhara. That means if he heard anything one time, he would remember it. And he, even as a boy, he memorized complete Bhagavad Gita and so many verses. So his initiative name was Sajjan Seva Das Brahmachari. And he was a nice Brahmachari all life. Our Param Gurudev engaged him all the time in such a way that he would get the blessings of all the Vaishnavas. Before the sadhana, he used to clean the floor, put down the asanas, put down all the leaf plates for everyone, put some piece of lemon and salt, because the salt and lemon would be in the dal, it changes the prakriti because they offer lemon. So he would do this for everyone, then serve everyone for prasadam, then after they finished, they would go and he would learn all the plates and clean everything. In the evening time, he was put cleaning the toilets. Who was doing very menial
services?
Just after the experience of Prabhupada about this kind of power, there was a tremendous conflict between different groups in the Gaudiya Mathas. And some devotees about those devotees who are with them. And then someone, they didn't do anything, but they were trying to avoid that. And they were arrested. Param Gurudev, Narahari Prabhu, even the teaching of Krishna Bhakti Maharaj, they were put in prison. Bhumi Maharaj, they were all put in prison.
Giving him a job and giving his food where he will stay every day.
And in 1954, our Father Gurudev gave all three sannyas on the same day. It became Sita Bhaktivedanta. Vama Gosoma, Sita Srikrama, and Sita Narayana.
Иногда по-разному. Господь просто сказал, что для вас
дай. Fifty shloks, one after another, from all over the Shastra school, that Krishna has created as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And then, after this book, we will be 50 shloks after another, and we will be able to read Rafa, and we will be able to read Rafa, and we will be able to read Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Without any pride, no one helped himself down, and no one could give an answer.
Очень смиренно, если ты был бы сделал, просто сделал арест, и никто не мог ничего ответить.
So, Srila Vana Maharaj, everyone considered him to be Gaudiya Vaishnava encyclopedia. And one time when he was very young, as Guru Krishnananda was saying, he used to work very late with the printing press, putting the letters in and the backwards, working machinery. And one time he was working very late, he worked very tired, and touched the ends of his fingers in the machine.
Однажды, как мы уже услышали, Ашрила Кришнананда, когда даже целый был молод, он работал за печатным станком целыми вещами, и однажды он сделал очень-очень станок, он очень писал, и вот этим станком он отрезал себе кончики губ.
So, our Maharaj Gurudev came there and saw him and the blood and how he was in pain. And Maharaj Gurudev was like, he had heard that the disciple is crying for Gurudev. But Maharaj Gurudev has such a shishya vatsala, such a parental love, he would cry sometimes for his disciple. So this is one very prominent occasion. So then Maharaj Gurudev personally took him from Navadvip to Calcutta and went to the hospital with him to make sure he was taken care of. And very miraculously, after some time, everything grew back perfectly.
И когда Маран Гурудев сам лично отвез его из Навадвипа в Калькутту, сам отдал его в больницу, где о нем позаботились, и через какое-то время очень скоро все мистическим образом просто заросло.
So, if our Maran Gurudev had some very big responsibility, some service which entailed great responsibility, he didn't used to give that to Srila Vama Maharaj, he used to give to Srila Tridhara Maharaj.
Если у Парама Гурудева было какое-то служение, какие-то очень серьезные обязанности, очень серьезное служение, которое подразумевало большую ответственность, то он не возлагал эти обязанности на Вама Махарадж, он давал их Шиле Тридхара Махараджа.
Шиле Тридхара Махарадж would argue with him and ask many questions and everything, and then when he was convinced, then he would go and do it and complete it.
И Шиле Тридхара Махарадж, он мог спорить, он задавал очень много вопросов, то есть его нужно было убедить, но когда он уже был убежден, тогда он все, он уходил, делал, делал, и все было прекрасно.
And the reason was because our Param Gurudev always used to see Srila Vama Maharaj like his child, so because he came when he was so young. Whereas Srila Tridhara Maharaj came when he was a mature person and experienced in the world, so he would give those types of
он не давал такие какие-то очень серьезные ответственные поручения ему. Он давал их Тридхара Махараджу, который уже пожил мирской жизнью и уже был более опытным.
Srila Vama Goswami Maharaj was a very brilliant speaker.
Srila Vama Goswami Maharaj был очень искусным оратором.
Very brilliant writer.
И удивительным писателем.
Sometimes after Navadvip Parikrama, thousands of devotees were there and coming for darshan with Srila Bhakti Prajnana Keshava Maharaj.
Иногда после Парикрама по Навадвипатхаме тысячи преданных приходили на даршан Шрила Бхакти Прагьяна Кешава Госвами.
While he was talking with them, he would call Srila Bhakti Maharaj, come here, take a pen.
И когда он разговаривал с ними, он вызывал к себе Шрила Бхакти Махараджа и говорил, иди сюда, возьми ручку.
And in between talking to the people and saying goodbye and giving them advice, he would dictate an article and Srila Vama Maharaj would write it down and no need editing, proofreading or anything. And he would print it that evening and then offer to Lord Nrisimhadev the next morning And the Patrika was distributed.
И когда эти люди приходили на Ардхадаршан, то когда выдавались какие-то буквально минутки, чтобы Барам Гурудев с ними попрощался, поздоровался, в это же время он быстро надиктовывал что-то, какую-то новую статью Бабани Махараджу, и тут очень быстро и очень правильно все писал. И буквально и не нужно было ни нужды ни в какой редакции. Все было идеально, тут же это отпечатывалось, и буквально на следующий день выходила печать.
And no mistake.
И не было ни одной ошибки.
Not like today.
Как сегодня.
Now we have computers.
Сейчас у нас есть компьютеры.
And we have 5 editors.
И 5 издателей.
And 3 proofreaders.
И 3
proofreaders. And when it's printed, still there's a mistake.
И все равно, когда что-то отпечатывается, видны ошибки.
So these personalities, they're from the transcendental world, they're not of this world.
Поэтому мы можем понять, что удивительные личности из трансцендентного мира. Не так, как мы.
One time, Srila Ramamurti himself, he said, that when he was a young devotee, then Param Gurudev came back from somewhere and gave him two pairs, not one, two pairs of shoes.
Однажды Шрила Рамамурти нам рассказывал, когда Param Gurudev вернулся с какого-то путешествия, он привез по целых две пары обуви.
Сатян Сейна said, really then, you are the guru when I am the disciple. I can bring you the shoes, but you are bringing my shoes and not one, two pairs. Why?
И тогда Саджан Севак сказал, о, Гурудев, вы мой гуру, я ваш ученик. Это ученик обычно носит обувь учителю, а тут вы приносите мне обувь, да еще и не одну пару, а целых две. Почему?
Then the Param Gurudev said, oh, one day, when you have many children, then you understand the love of father for the
children. И тогда Param Gurudev ответил, однажды, после вот этого пути, ты познаешь эту любовь к отца к своим детям.
Then Sayo was thinking, I was in a rut for so many years. Afterwards I'll be married and have
children.
And then years later he said, then I realized that that's what he was doing. He was giving the blessing. In the future you will have so many disciples. And after that I realized how Gurudev loves his such a sin. Maharaj was such a very beautiful speaker and such a gentleman. If he was cutting someone's arguments, but he spoke in such a tone that you cannot tell whether he's cutting that person's arguments or glorifying them.
И он делал это таким образом, что это не задевало человека, которому он говорил.
He was very humble.
Он был очень смиренным.
In Navadvip every year, on Gurpurim, thousands of people would come to him to ask for diksha, initiation. Junior god brothers, Sri Vikrama and to my Gurudev. And he used to bow down at their feet and beg them, please forgive me for this sinful act. I should also say, please forgive me for this sinful act. So, in this way, Srila Vaman was familiarized. He was the embodiment of Srinavana, the peaceful teacher. One time, the three god brothers, they were traveling and preaching with Srila Vaman Prabhupada Krishna Goswami, and that is how it is.
Однажды, в которой трактор путешествовали и проведывали, то, что на воздухе жили в Ахапрагене, я же в Атастане.
and each have their own responsibilities.
У каждого будет свои ответственности.
One have to go in charge of the tents and the lanterns. No electricity.
Один заведовал палатками, а также освещением, потому что тогда не было электричества, и были такие опасные.
My Guru Dev was in charge of the slide projector. Because even though it was many years ago, but Param Guru Dev, he used to use a screen and show slides because he knew thousands of villages who come. What is this? And for preaching, he used to do this. And my Guru Dev was in charge of that slide
projector. Но все равно Парам Гурудев использовал слайды от проповеди, потому что он знал, что это привлечет тысяч жителей деревень, которые подумают, что это такое интересное.
So then, one day, my Gurudev, he forgot to bring it.
И однажды мой Гурудев забыл то, что принести это.
And there was a big panda program.
А была очень большая программа запланирована.
So we went to show the program, and I said, oh, I forgot to bring the projector. Gurudev will be very angry.
И вот подошел
So then, Sri Trivikra Maharaj is just don't worry, leave it to me.
И тогда Тривикра Махарадж как отмахнулся, ты не переживай, предоставь это мне.
So before the program, he came to Srila Bhakti Prabhupada and Keshava and said, Guru Dev, because I guess there will be rain this evening. It's better that we don't use the projector this evening. It's better if you just give kata. And he said, yes, good idea. So I have seen in the last years of the pastimes of Srila Bhaktivinoda Bhavan Goswami. How he was doing bhajan. I have never seen anyone before and I never saw anyone afterwards like Srila Bhavan Maharaj.
Я никогда не видел никого ни до, ни после, чтобы походил на Шрилу Бхагавана
Госвами. Once I took a group of devotees to Phupadakram in Jaipur. And I met with his servant and discovered that secretly Srila Bhagavan was staying there on some days in Jaipur. And we went to visit him.
Однажды я проводил Харикраму с Кутангеда, как я водил в Джайпур, и от одного из слуг Махараджа мы узнали, что там секретно находится Бхагаван.
And he was sitting. He was a beautiful, like a divan, like a deity.
Он сидел там, он был прекрасен, как божество.
And continuously chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
Он продолжительно воспевал.
And he only stopped, put down his mala, then he prayed, Krishna Kirti Nagana, Paro, Premam, Kritambo, Nibande, Rupasanatano, Rindu, Siddhi, Rupalo, Sarva Swami has become Chaitanya, has become Yama, has become Radhika, has become Govardhan, has become and then remember the guy and then chanting and Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And he used to say, see everything. Hear everything, speak nothing.
И он всегда говорил, слушай все, смотри на все, но ничего не говори.
That was his message. If you want to do Bhagavad Bhajan, deep Bhajan, you can observe what's going on, you hear what's going on, don't give your own tikka, don't make any comment.
Если вы хотите совершать глубокий Bhagavad Bhajan, вы можете наблюдать за тем, что происходит, и что слышите, но никогда не давайте свою тихо, не давайте свою комментарий.
If there was some controversy or anything going on in the march, then all they wanted to come to him because he was a Jara president.
Когда какие-то проблемы, какие-то конфликты были в марте, то все преданные приходили к нему, потому что он был отчаянный президент.
And he would patiently listen to everything.
Он терпеливо слушал всех.
And he would say, I don't know anything about Srila Prabhupada.
И говорил, вы знаете, я ничего не
Ramamata and my Gurudev, that they must have friendship.
Некоторые люди, ну, такую делали пропаганду, будто бы Шилопатка давала Махараджи Парамамадев, не были друзьями.
This is completely false.
Это неправда.
And there are many examples from his life.
И можно привести очень много примеров из жизни.
Once in Navadvip, the ISKCON in Mayapur were having a big procession to celebrate Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur's appearance.
Однажды в Навадвипе, в ИСККОНе в Майапуре была очень большая процессия в честь дня явления Бхактисиддханта Сарасвати Такура.
So they invited many monks to come.
И они пригласили членов множества монахов.
And some devotees came to see the Lama Maharaja and asked that can we go.
Некоторые преданные подошли к Бхактисиддханте Бхактисиддханта Махараджа и спросили, можно ли мы пойти.
He said, yes, you can go. But don't come back.
Он сказал, да, вы можете пойти, но не возвращайтесь.
He said, why?
Они сказали, почему?
Because my brother, Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayana, he is now gone outside of India. First person in Bodhi Vedanta in India has gone outside of India and is preaching around the world. And wherever he is going, they are trying to block his preaching and make him famous. So until they change and they collaborate and apologize, they cannot have any connection or have any connection with anyone who has connection. He was very strict about
it.
It was the sign of his deep love and respect for our Lord. So that when Srila Rama Maharaj left this world, it was this day, in fact it's so my Guru day was here in Prashadam to go over them with 1,000 devotees. When the news came that he had left, and before he left, he told, I want Srila Narayana Maharaj to do my samadhi.
И когда был год, уже шли Рама Махараджа, Махарадж был здесь, он на Гарадхане с очень многими преданными, и тут же, когда услышал звонок, потому что отправляли этот день Рама Махарадж, то он тут же поехал туда, и Рама Махарадж попросил, чтобы Нарайана Махарадж совершил приехал и совершил это сама.
So he left on this day at midnight, he entered into the Nisha Lila, nine times, last pastimes of Radha Krishna, as Radha Vanjali.
И в полночь этого дня он нашел Нитя Лилы, начали Лилы Радхи Кришны, как Радха
Ванты. And our Gurudev, leaving 1,000 devotees and his own parikrama, immediately went there to oversee the ceremony. But some brothers, some younger devotees, before he came, they did everything. It was not popular respectful. But anyway, he went there and offered arti and did parikrama and paid his respects to Srila Rama.
И тут же, оставив всех преданных, оставив всю свою парикраму, Гурудев отправился туда, совершил самадхи. И некоторые более молодые преданные уже совершили церемонию, что было не очень правильно, но тем не менее, Гурудев тут же туда отправился и присутствовал при этом и выразил свое глубочайшее почтение Бабе Махараджу.
So we are indebted to these three great personalities.
И мы очень обязаны этим трем великим личностям.
We know that when our Srila Bhakti Prajnana Kesha Goswami disappeared from this world, they did not compete with each other to try to become acharya. But rather, there was one election and they voted for each other. So in the end, our Gurudev and Srila Tridhakar Maharaj, they begged Srila Bhava Maharaj, you are more senior, and you are to us, and you are worshipable to us, please, on our request, and for service of Gurudev, accept this position of Acharya. So it was on the request of his godbrothers that he accepted that part, that the asana, not out of his own design.
Просто умоляли его, они сказали, ты для нас старший, и мы очень причиняем тебе, пожалуйста, прими этот титул для служения с нашим Гурудевом, пожалуйста, стань чайником. И тогда лишь бы просили просьбу о согласии с молчанием.
My Guru Dev said, sometimes I tell very beautiful katha and I'm very happy. And if others say that katha was very beautiful, I feel such joy. But said my Guru Dev, Srila Rama Maharaj, he would speak very beautifully, but he never wanted to hear anything.